Hello student, once again welcome to my YouTube channel Kunal GeoGIS. This is our fourth lecture of MA/MSc Geography, Geographical Thought. First three lectures you studied about the Greek geographers, Roman geographers and Indian geographers. So today we will discuss about the Arab geographers. On Arab geographers, already asked a question in a UPSC mains exam. So everyone studied this topic carefully. So let's begin to our today's lesson, contributions of Arab geographers. Arab geographers valuable contribution to the geographical thought, their Western counterpart. The Arab geographers were the great contributor in the field of mathematical, physical and regional geography. Their achievement in climatology, oceanography, geomorphology and as well as determination of cardinal point and limits of habitable worlds. The Arab geographers has an open mind nature, and the journey during the pilgrimage for trade and their main adventures added to their geographical knowledge. Arab, largely influenced by the Greek geographers, adapted the Greek ideas about the shape and size of the earth. Arab geographer considered the earth as the center of the universe around which the seven planets revolve. So let's discuss about the main Arab geographers one by one. So our first geographer is Muhammad Abul Qasim, known as Ibn Hakam. So Ibn Hakam or Muhammad Abul Qasim, he was born in Nasibin. He was a resident of Baghdad. He's interested in books of travel and modes of life of various tribes and nation, and as well as he described the countries and their rivers and other water bodies, resources and trade and important routes in Arab worlds. And he also described the Caspian Sea is not connected to the Northern Ocean, and he also described the Europe as a Iceland country. Our second Arab geographer, Al-Masudi. Al-Masudi was also born from Baghdad, and he was not only the geographer, he was also historian as well as the world traveler. Al-Masudi was a very important scholar of the 10th century. He had a view of Earth, the spherical shape, and he described the Caspian Sea is not connected to Northern Sea, as well as also described the weather condition, and he tried to resolve controversy of the source of the Nile and reported the phenomena of the monsoonal wind. He was also divided the world into seven regions on the basis of language, and his important work in Mihraj al-Duwab, Kitab Akbar Zaman. Here you can see here Mihraj al-Duwab, Kitab Aswat and Kitab Akbar Zaman. Our third Arab geographer, Al-Biruni. Al-Biruni's full name was Abu Rayyan Muhammad. He was greatest geographer of his time, and he studied the Greek works, thought, and he studied the Greek works, thought, and the Arabic translation, and then Arabic translation, and he approved the Earth theory of rotation its axis and correctly calculated the latitude and many places. He was also explained the solar and lunar eclipse, and then he also studied the relationship of the tides with the phases of moon, and attempted to measure the longest and the shortest distance of moon and the sun from the earth. In Kitab al-Hina, is regarded his monumental works which deals with geography of India, and he was the first Arab geographer to provide valuable and correct information about the Indus and its origin as well as the flood. And he had also studied Indian cultural and Hindu beliefs. Our third Arab geographer is Al-Idrisi, greatest scholar of the 12th century. Al-Idrisi travel in south, north and west Europe, and he described the courses of river, and he was not agree about the Greek classification of the world into five climatic division. In his work, map considered the most valuable contribution to geography, and Al-Idrisi's was the description about the Sicily. Description about the Sicily, Iceland. For our next geographer, Al-Balkhi, he was collected the climatic data, and they went to different region and asked how the weather condition was there. For example, we asked to other person and how it was the cold days, then how it rained. Just like Al-Balkhi asked a lot of people and mentioned in his work, in their book. And Al-Balkhi, he was prepared the world first climatic atlas based on the that data in Kitab Al-Ashkal in 921. Our next Arab geographer, Ibn Battuta. You also listen the song Ibn Battuta. So Ibn Battuta spent 28 years in travel and crossed the distance of more than 75,000 miles, and he described in his book Real Land provided into the agriculture, economy, soil, as well as the political history of the Muslim world, and his description of house types and building material in different region, and this information was very informative. And Ibn Battuta also described the physical condition of various region that he was visited. Next is Ibn Khaldun. Ibn Khaldun's main work, the Northern Hemisphere, is more densely populated than the southern hemisphere, and the population along the equator is sparse because of inhabitable condition, and up to 16 degree latitude centralization is increased, but the after 60 degree north and 60 degree south the population is declining. His explanation for tidal role is very important for the origin of settlement. And Ibn Khaldun considered as one of the early environmental in scientific ways. He discussed the rise and fall dynasty and empire in political geography. In our another Arab geographer, Ibn Sina, he gave the ideas of landscape erosion, observed the river stream, and he was also examined the presence of fossils in the rocks in the highest mountain. And our another geographer is Al-Dinwari. Al-Dinwari's books on main books on plant geography, and he's mainly focus on correcting the wrong concept as well as greatest achievement in field of astronomy and mathematical geography. Here you can read this. He's discussed the plant evolution from its birth to its death, as well as he also deals with the earth science in the context of agriculture. And he was the astronomer, agriculturist, botanist, geographer, mathematician, and as well as greatest historian. So this is notes for you, so please read carefully. This is for useful for your examination, like MAMSC geography second, as well as also important for a competitive exam. Here given the contribution to climatology of Arab geographers, contribution in geomorphology, as well as contribution in oceanography. So note down this slide. So all the above Arab geographers made the valuable contribution to the geography. So I hope you understand about the Arab geographer. So next lecture we will see about the Marco Polo, Christopher Columbus, Captain Cook, Vasco da Gama, etc. So see you in the next lecture. Thank you.